Okay, so the horror one, just to tidy this one up and finish it off, I want to add one of our zombies because we haven't actually added a zombie. And stick him there, and he needs this thing severed. Right? Yeah, I think I left it with a next frame, just kind of coming over here as for testing. Just get rid of that. We don't need it. There's nothing there. Right? Because we don't want him to attack instantly. But what we do want is just a trigger. That's kind of like that somewhere. Get rid of this stuff. Mark this as a trigger. Add an FSM. Trigger event with player. Just needs to go. This can send event to a game object, to this zombie, to attack. And when the player walks in the room, the zombie will attack. I was playing around with boxes and I made this. All it is a cube. Well, 10 cubes. But yeah, it's literally just some cubes. Just playing around with some cubes. Right, so we have this door. So I put a cube on this door, just attached it, put some little cubes in it, just for looks. And I thought it'd be kind of cool if we could have, for example, our game manager, player HUD, and player. Those don't need to be off. So we have, that's our pools, that's that, that's our trigger. Like, just stick him over somewhere. He doesn't need to be anywhere special. What else? Where can we stick this? That's our pause menu. I guess just on this guy. And we're going to make a thing called access code. And all it's going to do is we need a variable that is a integer. Access code. Up on a capital, because I'd like to. Shouldn't use spaces, use underscores if need be. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a random int, which is 0 to 9 inclusive. And this is going to be number 1. And copy. Paste and paste and paste, and this one's going to be number 2 and number 3 and number 4. And I'm doing it this way to ensure we have 4 digits. So int operator need 3 of those. So 1, 2, 2, 10, multiply, you can just store it back in 2, and 3, multiply, store it back in 3, and 4, multiply, store it back in 4, and then int add move to the bottom, make sure everything's in this the right order. So we'll take 4 and we're going to add 1 copy and paste before, and we're going to add two, paste, add three. Okay, so a crap load of actions just for one little number. So here, I'm going to stick this over here. If we hit a number or hit play, we should get two, four, six. We have 6, 6, 4, 2. Oh, I never transferred it over. Yeah, so I mean four is the right thing, right? That's, there's four. Okay, so just at the end, just for the ways of naming, set int value access code is the same as 4. There, so now if we hit play, we have a random access code, 7331. And 3442, right? Just a random number. So the other thing is this guy here. We should have get owner inspecting object. Inspecting object is a global. Okay, so this HUD, we're going to use this global object. So if we had a, let's say, a book, right, I don't know, here, I'll create an object. It doesn't need to be nearly this big. That taking child into that. Oh no, can't do that. Edit, undo parenting. Let's create an empty, and both of these can sit inside the empty. There we go. That we can do. So here we have this little book. This book, if we add an FSM and we do a tag book, we have here our interaction. Let's take a look at this. So let's add another one called book. Oh, Lord Tunner, what am I doing? Book. Right, so if we have ammo, we're setting this thing. And we can almost copy that. Just about. Right, because then we can come down here, but we don't want pick up ammo, we want read book. We can activate it, we don't want to set this one up. Well, I suppose we could. Set that up, that's general item pickup. So if it's not equal null, we get it, we get need a spring switch. Or rally, get FSM. Hit object tag. So the tag we're looking at is book. And this will now get we need to get FSM int, and we happen to store it in the same place, so that's convenient. Get the access code. Have a little little text up here. And let's make it a little bigger. A little too big. And let's give it a wider text. Out, put it in the middle, go best fit, take away the breakcast, and deactivate it, and call it talk. So, in general pickup, if we see said thing, we need a reference to talk. So, UI text set text, and we need a build string. So build string is two. We want it says and access code separator. This will set this talk with set string wait, and we need to activate it. Weight down 1.2 and finish. And when we finish, let's copy that guy, bring him down here and deactivate him, and just finish that and go back to here. All right, so now we have this book, which actually needs the tag book, and he has an FSM, and I don't know why. So I should have maximized play on that one. I put the tag on the wrong thing. I put it here and there's no collider there, right? If I was smart, let's get rid of those and add the just add a box collider here or something. Shrink it down because it doesn't need to be all that crazy. Offset's way off. Okay, so I'm just going to literally zero that. That's where those books should be. Alright, you can sit there. You can sit there. And then just over a bit. Now, this guy's got the book. Expand it. There we go. So there's that, and it's still not picking up. Shift-P, so camera holder, oh, you know what, totally forgot, we have all our interactions happening on this little thing, right? So now we have this book, and it says 8526. Right. So and transfer it over there. So yeah, it has some weird thing happening with our AI. That was in this room. So there's our AI. Was there, oh, navigation's fine. Alright, we'll deal with that after. So what this guy needs, this cube, he's on the right thing. Let's give him a keypad. Alright, so now he has keypad. And if keypad, that's our inspector. So if keypad, so we need a panel just like that. And let's go to 2D and shrink it down because we don't need it covering the whole page. Something like that. Darken it, solid, darken it some more, just going to duplicate it, up here, darken it a little more, let me lighten this one up just a tad, take this one and just shrink them down in. There we go. Let's put these into an object called keypad. D-pad, let's give that a UI text. Set here. And let's best fit, put that nice and white. Zero it off. Sure, that looks good. And let's create another empty. This is where our buttons are going to be. And it's going to have a grid layout group. And I'm just going to add a button. Like that. And these can be a lot smaller. And fixed row count of 3. And let's go 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Let's give that some spacing. And let's give that some buttons. We need to stick this guy a little more in the middle. There we go. I don't think I'm gonna bother going with all of these, but I mean, obviously if you're doing this you'd want to, right? You can change all these so that they match up nicely. Just to, you know, obviously it looks better, but not that worried about it right now. FSM. So button array. And what we want, we have 9 buttons. And all we're going to do is put these in the proper order. Actually, you know what? Let's go with 10, and let's be sneaky about this. Let's make 1 extra. And then, oh, we can't put them there, though. This will just avoid some math that we have to do. You'll see why. I know it's weird. And then just going to deactivate him. So that first one is going to be that weird deactivated one. He does nothing. Don't worry about him. In fact, I'm going to turn off his raycast. So we can't even click him even if we wanted to. And he's non-interactable. So now, and drag all these guys in. And 6, 7, 8. There we go. So now all of these things need an event, technically. Doesn't really matter, I'm just gonna they can all use the same event. Here's the important part. Button pressed. Okay, so we now have a button pressed as an int. And we are going to sequence event this whole thing. And we're going to have the events of 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. 2, 3, 4, 5. So on the very first sequence of this, we are going to int to string. Button pressed to button pressed string. Format of 4 digits and finish. Everything's going to come down to here. This guy is going to UI text set text. There we go. And finish. Bloop. So, but if we get number 2, it's a little different, right? We can't just convert the string because we still need this first one. So we get we can almost take a temp int set. We can set this right now as a button pressed in this one, but here we now want to int operator, and we're going to take the button pressed times it by 10, and we can store it as button pressed int add. The button pressed, we can add now our temp, and then we will copy and paste temp is button pressed and finish and go. Oop. And go. And I'm just going to copy this guy and paste him. So this guy is obviously going to be a little different because now he's times 100. And we're going to add the temp and this guy together, and we set that. And he's going to come down here, copy, paste, same idea. Oh, this guy doesn't need 5 sequence events. Times 1,000. Now we have this. Now, at the other thing we need to do is we are going to do this a slightly different. This guy is not going to go to that one. These three will go here and just loop around waiting for button presses. But this guy, after he sets that, he's going to come here and do the same thing with that setting. But he's also get FSM int from the access code and we're going to int compare. Access code to button pressed, right? Because we're adding the temp. We don't care about this part actually. We can technically get rid of that. The button pressed. So button pressed. Now, if these are equal, open. If it's less, you have failed, and if it's greater, you have failed. Open. So there's open, and there is fail. And if we fail, let's go like this so that we know. Oh, yeah, it's the other thing. So, keypad, self, right? So, if we are now here, and we hit the interaction, and we now see a 6 guy, And it is keypad. Now do keypad. There we go. And copy him. So he will do that. General pickup will say keypad. All right, because now we want some action to go with it. And the action is button get key down. We're going to hit the E. And we're going to say use we want this guy to be open. Let's just go there. So the other thing we need is like the inspector, is when we inspect things, that's to take the item. We want, where's the AE? What's that? Keys. Door interactor. Inspector. So we can, yeah, this is the stuff I was looking for. Should probably organize this stuff a lot better, eh? So, okay, so we have, if it's got an inspect, we're going to inspect an item. It activates stuff. It sets all this position of things.
Chew! Oh, bless me.
We need this guy right there. Right, because that's more or less what we want to do, the same thing.
Oh yeah,
I've had nothing but bad luck about copying and pasting with the new stuff for this PlayMaker. Where is player? Player and under health. Disable. But there's no enable. I don't think that's right. There we go. So, but he's going to go back over here. So I'm going to copy that. I don't know if this is a smart idea. We're going to stick it here anyways. We'll see what happens. Put it to enable. Wait a minute. Is that... See, activates. He's going there. Yeah, okay. So, let's hit play and see what happens. Thank you. Damn it, I forgot to change that thing while we were there. Alright, so both those things, we're just going to give those things a book and put them on that. That should just. It says 5217. Keypad? I don't think so. Keypad? Nope, we didn't. Man, I do that a lot, eh? Okay, so, and its collider is probably underneath this guy. I'm going to raise him out so we can see him. Use keypad. So that's being seen. And he is. So he's going there. Use keypad, and he sets that cube. And this guy. Item equals false. So we're here, item is equal to null, so that's false, and I'm supposed to hit the E, which I didn't do, so I'm there. Okay, now what's happening? So we get keypad, string is keypad, and I didn't spell it right, I didn't have, this is why proper spelling is super important. It really doesn't take much. So we hit E, and this guy. Yes, yeah, I didn't realize we had an E there as well. Right? We actually don't need that E. We can get rid of this whole state and just come straight into here. Double hit it then. Right, so we hit E, we get this guy. So. Now we have that little issue with that, right? Because now we need a way to disable that stuff. Because if I disable this, not that part. Where is the player? Let's get rid of that. No, we can't get rid of that. He's part of it. Okay, so first of all, we need this part. This can be gone. I don't need it. We've already got one. This part needs to be a capital P. When we bring this up, we need a way. Okay, our player, and we disable, what do we do? The camera look, and we set that, and that's fine. The mouse portion happens here, I believe. Yes. So we would need here in general pickup. He's finishing. So he's looping. Alright, now we're just gonna get a key down to close this thing. So we don't have some sort of crazy loop. Oh. Finish. Go there. Set mouse cursor. Move this to the top. To unhide. Copy. And let's put it right here just before we go back into here. That's hide and lock. Okay. Let's see if that's resolved a few of those issues. Thing out. Jeez. Alright, cube. A keypad. And let's bring it out here. Like it's underneath that collider, so it's good to go. So we use it. Use it. Okay, let's see why it is still being a pain in my bum. What do we have? General pickup. Is this one says E. So let's make sure we hit E. And I thought I changed that. Except for I accidentally deleted the Y. That's not right. So E. There we go. Stop that gun. Error. Yes, error is right. 4. So, why? If we do it twice, keypad. So we go into here, it's doing 11. That is right. Convert into string. Button pressed. That. Button pressed. We never do convert it back over. Oh, we totally missed that. Right, because we're converting an int to a string here, right? like it sees the int. It wants to use the int, but we never. So, convert int to string, copy, paste it here, and we want button pressed, and button pressed string. We just forgot that one little step there. And we'll fix this guy while we're here, bring him out. Okay, make sure he's tagged. Okay, and this guy, we still had a little issue here. him, missing the Y. Okay. But anyways, you at least get the idea for that one, and this video's probably gone on long enough. But anywho, so yeah, if once you get the random generated number, it will just match. Right? Nope, not from the access code. From this guy. Right? Because, and then when you open, you just open up the animator. And then it will, like I said, it'll either fail and show the error, or it'll open. We have a keypad with a randomly generated number that's in somewhere else you can read. It's pretty good, but I really don't know what else to really push into this little first-person horror thing. Like I said, there's a lot of polish and stuff that could obviously happen, all sorts of things, a lot of organizational things. Some touch-ups and stuff, but I really don't want to drag it on too long, though. I don't know. We'll see. Anyways, we'll see you guys in the next video.